Let's take a look inside the production process for bacteria at this plant. Here, we ferment, freeze-dry and package approximately 500 bacterial products for thousands of customers. All the bacteria we produce here are used in our range of silage inoculants and animal health and nutrition products. The process starts in the laboratory area, where bacterial culture required for production is tested for purity on agar plates. We take the culture required, which is stored in a small vial from a minus 80 degrees centigrade freezer. All our bacteria are stored here. This ensures our bacterial strains are in good condition and ready for the production process. They're tested on a regular basis for strain purity. Once the vial has been tested for purity, it is used to inoculate a bigger specialized vessel we call a fermenter. In a sterile fume cabinet, the vial is transferred to a syringe. This is then used to seed the fermenter. The bacteria will then multiply from a few million to many billions. The bacteria in the syringe are aseptically added to a 10-liter fermenter, which contains a growth media specific to the bacterium. This is left for a specific time period to allow the bacteria to multiply to the correct level. Once completed, this will be used to seed a much bigger fermenter. At this site, we have a variety of fermenters in sizes ranging from 10 liters to 14,000 liters. Fermenters are specialized pressurized vessels, which for our purposes are used to multiply a bacterium into several trillion of the same bacterium. This is achieved using specific growth media, dependent on the bacterium being grown. But all media contains liquid yeast extract, sugars and minerals to varying levels, all of which are sterilized in the fermenters. Fermenters are run at set temperatures, pH levels and oxygen levels, based on the characteristics of the bacterium being grown at the time. The temperature, pH and oxygen are controlled automatically via computer control units. The goal is to produce bacteria in their most energetic state, and these parameters are crucial. The fermentation time is dependent on the bacterium being produced, but it generally takes 8 to 12 hours, although some bacterium can take days. When bacteria are at their optimal growth level, they are once again tested in the laboratory to ensure there is no contamination. The 10-liter seed fermentation is then used as the seed and transferred to the production scale fermenters ranging from 7 to 14,000 liters. Once the fermentation cycle is complete, the next stage in the production process requires us to separate the bacteria from the liquid growth media as gently as possible to ensure they are not stressed or damaged. A centrifuge is used to separate the bacterial solids from the fermentation growth solution. It does this by spinning liquids at very high speeds. This centrifuge is what is called a continuous feed, as the liquid from the fermenter is continuously fed into the centrifuge. The centrifuge spins at such a high speed that the bacteria are pushed out of the media, where they collect as solids, which we call biomass, and are stored in an internal drum. The spent growth media is removed directly to a waste tank, then transferred to farmers for use as a fertilizer. The next stage requires us to mix the biomass paste with cryoprotectants. This helps protect the bacteria through the freeze-drying process of manufacture. We then pour the bacterial paste into specialist trays, which are then transferred into the freeze dryer, where they are frozen to approximately minus 45 degrees centigrade. Before commencing the freeze-drying process, it is vital that our team wear protective clothing to safeguard themselves and ensure there is no contamination within the chamber of the dryer. Freeze-drying is a dehydration process typically used to preserve perishable materials such as bacteria. This process consists of freezing the bacterial paste, then reducing the surrounding pressure. This allows the frozen water in the material to sublimate directly from the solid phase to the gas phase. This means the bacteria paste dries without exposure to high temperatures, something that can easily damage bacteria. The dried material takes the form of a honeycomb structure, and this is milled into a fine powder, which will be used to formulate the final product. The milled powder is then tested in the lab to check viability and quality. This is a blending drum where we add to the bacterial powder and other raw materials to make the final formulated product. These include bacterial powders, enzymes, flow enhancers, moisture scavengers, and various other components. The drum is designed to rotate at speeds required to make sure all the powders are universally mixed without harming the bacteria. The final stage of production requires the formulated powder to be placed in pre-formed oxygen barrier sachets, which ensure product longevity. The sachets are filled, sealed, and batch-coded automatically on a specialist machine. The weights of the sachets are monitored. If the sachet is not the correct weight, it will be removed by the machine to a reject container. Once filled, the sachets are classed as work in progress. This allows the final product to be rigorously quality control checked to ensure each bacterium and enzymes are at specification. We also check for dissolvability and flowability. Only after quality control has released each batch can the sachet be labeled and boxed, then quality control checked one final time before delivery to the customer. Larger bulk item products are stored in a purpose-built warehouse, where they're assigned to specific locations. Stock level is monitored daily via a computerized system. Lallemand Animal Nutrition, specific for your success.